Okay, get ready for a ton of information. Over the next little bit, what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain how organizations can stay relevant with the industry right now, because it has been crazy, and what consumers are wanting is so different than what we've ever had before. So the industry right now, you've seen a huge disruption within anything retail, right? You've seen all of these online businesses coming in and disrupting how convenient things are. You've seen grocery go through a dip and then have a resurgence with all of the COVID that's been going on. And so what do you do after the COVID pandemic is done? What do you do when expectations now from consumers is even higher because of all of the online shopping that they've done this last year? So what we've done is we've pulled information from many different resources to then provide a clear way that as an organization, you can stay relevant. So we have this, we pulled this information from McMullen Doolittle out of Chicago. And if you've heard of the value triangle, it's very similar. For businesses to stay relevant with all of the technology that's been going on and all of the expectations that people now have, is what they said is you need to have an extreme focus in one of these three areas for you to actually keep customers coming back and for you to stay relevant and keep them loyal. So the first one that you have to choose out of is you have to offer an extreme low price. So what does that even mean? Well, extreme low price now means that you've got to have an infrastructure in place, that you've cut out any extra costs, that you have your margins and your supply chain dialed down. So some good examples of this is one is a grocery chain called Aldi. Now, a traditional grocery store has, you know, between 40 to 45,000 different SKUs, where Aldi reportedly only has 700. And out of that, they produce 590 themselves. So what does this mean? This means that they're able to buckle down and they're able to cut out any middleman and they're able to manufacture a product and then resell it for a greater margin off of that. But to do this is you have to be so strategic. It requires you to really look at your organization down to the very bottom. Southwest Airlines is another great example of extreme low price. So we came across this article that talks about how they're so focused on extreme low price. So the CEO was quoted in there saying, "If you want to know how to run a low-cost fare airline, you're focused on being the low-cost airline." So when someone came to their marketing group and they said, "Hey, our surveys are telling us that people want salad and chicken on the flights. What do we do?" And the CEO says, "Wait, we will not be serving salad because that does not make us the low-cost airline. And so we cut out everything to make it to where we are the winners in that category." So if you're going after the low-cost category, you've got to make sure that you've got your infrastructure in place to actually do it, or else it's a race to the bottom. So the second offering is extreme convenience. So extreme convenience would probably be most aware of Amazon. So what they've done, and they were one of the first ones to do it, they disrupted the customer journey. So traditionally, you would have someone that would go to a store, they would look at a product, they'd put the product in their basket, they would shop, they would check out, they would load the product into their car, then they would take it home, then they would use it. What Amazon did is they took this really long process and they made it easier. They took out that you don't have to go to the store, or that you can look at other stores and still buy it from them right there. They took out that you don't have to go shopping through aisles and aisles of product. And then they took out that you've got to load it yourself. So you go on to the app, you search a keyword, you purchase it, and then it's shipped right to your door. Another example of extreme convenience is Airbnb. So they've disrupted the travel industry. So if you wanted an authentic experience before Airbnb, an authentic meaning like you're in the environment, you're not at a hotel, you would have to either know somebody that has a home or some type of residence within, let's say within the middle of Vietnam, or you would have to go in and purchase it yourself. So what Airbnb has done is they've connected with other people who own things, and then you use your device to then go and stay at their place to have that authentic experience. So it cuts out all of the middle part of you having to purchase something, having to set up residency and all of that. So they've disrupted it by making that customer journey easier. Now this, the extreme convenience is going to make its way into all of our businesses. But to be the winner at extreme convenience, you have to make sure that you've boiled down and you have a very specific strategy in place and you have the infrastructure and the technology know-how to do so. So the third one out of extreme low price, extreme convenience, is extreme experience. Now this one requires the least amount of infrastructure in place, meaning you don't have to revamp your entire business to do it. So it has the lowest cost of entry, but it does give you more overhead. So I'll use a couple different companies as an example. So one is the Starbucks Roastery. So what they've done is they have invested more into their space and into their people who are meeting with their guests. And so when you walk into a Starbucks Roastery, you see the theater. It's almost like a Willy Wonka of coffee. You see the theater of the coffee going around. The baristas are dressed up. They look like a small neighborhood coffee shop. That you go in and you have this dialogue and they're very educated on what it is that they're offering and how it is that they're explaining it. And so Starbucks is invested in the experience when you enter in. Another great example is Disney. And I'll show you some more examples from Disney. But Disney has gone in and their whole platform for their Disney parks is experience. Their cast members have different allowances to then enhance your experience. All of the lands that they have are designed to offer you a very immersive experience within that park. So when all of the pieces started coming together is when we took a trip to Disney World several years ago. So we drive up and we're unloading the car. So we're getting our kids in the car seats and we're starting to walk in, right? And the anticipation is starting to rise. Everybody is getting so excited. So as we walk through the gates, we hear music. And then we see all of the people around us and how excited they're getting. And as we're walking through, we start to notice that there's smells, there's popcorn, and there's churros. And so our adrenaline and our excitement just kept increasing. And during this time, we were in the thick of trying to figure out what are they doing that's providing such an intense and immersive experience for our family and for all of the guests. And so we walk from land to land. And we dissect what is it that's making a difference. So we notice the setting. All of the textures are changing. The signs are changing. The colors, what we're walking on. Everything around us ties in together. We start to notice that their cast members within each of the areas are very immersed in that environment that they're offering. They're dressed different, they act different, they treat you as if you're in that actual place. So then we started really watching and saying, okay, what else is happening? So as we would go from land to land, we noticed that all of their product offerings were changing. How they displayed the products were different. How we interacted with them were different. And then, after we started putting this together, we noticed that their setting looked different. We noticed that their products were different. We noticed that the branding was subtly changing. How we were interacting on our devices started enhancing the experience because we became more inquisitive of what was around us. And their people were making a difference. So a great example of this is my daughter was very into Elsa. So she was so excited to get dressed up as Elsa. So we have been walking around the park for several hours and she really wanted a balloon. So we set off down Main Street to find someone that had a balloon. And then finally when we located someone, we started to approach him and then he bowed. So he's holding all these balloons and he's bowing, pretending that she's actually Elsa. So then as we're engaging with them, she steps closer and he pretends that he's frozen. And so what he did is he created this whole theater around selling the balloon. He made this little girl, my daughter, feel so special, and our entire family was just ecstatic. And so what did that do? It made us like lifelong loyalists. It's insane because Disney is always able to offer and push your experience just a little bit farther. And we had another experience at Disney to where my youngest daughter was in Africa and she had this bright yellow dress and she had been spinning around and one of the workers from the restaurant came and brought her a cupcake that had the same color as her dress. So my daughter was so taken aback and felt so special. And what does that do for everybody who's paying for the experience? It makes us say, wow, this was worth it. I feel like I've walked into another land. I feel like I've disconnected from where I've came from. What I'm able to purchase in here is helping me remember the experience. The people, the cast from Disney has put such a touch on our interactions that we feel like we're people within their environment. So after this experience, what we did is we went back and we broke it all down and we grouped it together and said, okay, if we were to articulate this or if we were to actually have a system around this, how would we explain it? So what we've done is we've created what we call the train analogy. And everything falls in with this. So as a business, you start off and at the start of the train, there's strategy. So if you bring back to any of the companies that I've referenced, they have to say, we are going to offer an extreme experience. What is it that's going to bring in our guests and how are we going to evolve over time? What do we stand for? So this first train car drives all of the rest because what the leadership and what the company decides here dictates the rest of the five cars. So after your strategy, that's where you start to develop your brand. And then from your brand, this is where you look at your colors. This is where you look at how you're presenting your face, what people perceive you as. After you've got your brand established, then you move into the setting. So how are you taking your strategy and your brand and building it into an environment that feels different, that feels authentic, that tells a story, that brings people in to your organization and has them interact in a whole new way? From setting, you have digital. So this is the component of you do need to have convenience within your business. So how are you incorporating that? E-commerce, or do you have an app? Do you have something that makes their life easier while they're interacting with your business? From digital, you have people and process. And this is a big train car. This people and process makes such a difference on the experience that your guests have, how easy it is for you to train your people. This has everything to do with the touch that you can leave that's different than everybody else because it's how you train your people. And then the very last one is the product that you're offering. What are you offering that's different than everybody else? What are you offering that only you can do in a unique way? What is going to draw people in? So with all six of these train cars, this is how you go through and you create an experience. Is you're very deliberate in each one and you have a plan. And you have a strategy started from the beginning to where you know what's happening between now, the next 3 years, and where you want to be in 10 years. Okay, it's a lot of information, right? So how do you even figure out where you are with each of those six train cars? Well, what we've done as a company is we have developed a survey where you go in, you and your leadership go in and you score yourselves. So it will ask you 25 different questions, and the questions all start adding up. And at the very end, your emailed score, your overall score between 1 and 100, and then a score for strategy, for branding, for setting, digital, people, process, and product. And then this gives you the base of where it is that you need to start. After you have your scores, what do you do? Because you know that you need to increase it, right? Or maybe you don't need to increase all of them. Maybe there's just one or two that you're really focusing on. So we've developed toolboxes and lessons to help you go in to where we've pulled in information from experts interacting with hundreds of companies over the last 25 years. So that as a leadership team and as a company, you can go in and increase your score within each of them. So say you're low in strategy. We have several lessons here that you can go in and start figuring out what your strategy is. Start creating a game plan, because then you'll use those lessons and that information within your branding and your setting, etc. So these toolboxes will help you break through and start the conversations and give you somewhere to begin. And then from here, if you're the one running it, it means that you're not having to carry the whole thing by yourself. Now your entire organization will have the tools and the information to create this experience that you want, and they'll know how to do it. And then at the very end, what we do to help your experience succeed is then we translate it into your setting. Because we have been able to interact with you from the very beginning, we're able to take all of your information and translate it into an extreme experience within your space. And so this is a lot of information to absorb, but this is what will make a difference for small companies and organizations, meaning you're not Target and Amazon, because you're able to go in and maximize your budget. Instead of just putting whole teams on each of these train cars, you can decide from the very beginning, what is it that you need to do? Where is it that you're going? Who is it that you're wanting to become? And then your whole company gets behind that. And then you can really push it forward. So we are so passionate about helping organizations succeed, because if we don't do something, if as an industry we don't do something, these giants, they're going to overrun all of these small businesses, and that changes our communities, and that changes the way that we interact with each other. And so bring it back to your team. As an organization, do you want to stay relevant? Do you want to have engagements from your guests? And when are you going to start? And how are you going to start?